Newman says 0-3 Real Madrid. Gareth Bale among the goals on first start since September, 5 talking points. Gareth Bale's penalty helped Real Madrid virtually book their place in the quarterfinals of the Copa del Rey, but there was precious little other than the result to please Zinedine Zidane from a labored display against second division Newmansha. The Welshman coolly slotted home from the spot 10 minutes before half-time. Yet, despite being reduced to 10 men on the hour mark when Pape Diavanka rightly saw red, Newmansha were inches away from an equalizer when Inigo Perez's long-range effort came back off the underside of the bar. Bale lasted just an hour himself but offered little other than the penalty. Isco somehow blasted over with the goal at his mercy 7 minutes from time, but too late goals put an unmerited gloss on the score line for the visitors. Firstly, Isco converted Real's second penalty of the night before Borja Mayer allowed it a third in stoppage time. 1. New Year, no new Madrid. Zidane promised Madrid would come back in 2018 stronger than ever following an El Clásico humbling at home to Barcelona to close 2017. However, a side containing 10 changes from that defeat produced little to inspire confidence. A sudden upturn in form is around the corner. Real will really be judged when the likes of Cristiano Ronaldo, Luka Modric and Sergio Ramos return, but it was their depth of squad that proved so decisive en route to a La Liga and Champions League double. By contrast, at the moment Real's reserves are doing little to push the veterans for a more regular place in the side. 2. Bale not a ready-made Ronaldo replacement. Bale showed he can fill Ronaldo's in one sense alone by taking responsibility in the Portuguese's absence from the penalty spot. Otherwise the Welshman was only fleetingly involved, never threatening to dominate the game in a manner Madrid fans would have wished to see in an inexperienced lineup. Given Bale's injury record, it wasn't surprising to see his run out last just an hour, but it means he has still to complete 90 minutes since September. 3. Up for the cups. It hasn't been the season Madrid hoped for so far, but could yet be one that most clubs dream of when it comes to silverware. Real have lost just one cup tie in Zidane's 2 years in charge and already have 3 trophies to their name this campaign in the UEFA and Spanish Super Cups added to the Club World Cup. A mammoth 14-point gap to Barcelona in La Liga means Madrid are obliged to look to cup competitions for more joy in 2018 with the Copa del Rey a chance for redemption rather than the New Year distraction it often is. 4. Madrid survive Soria. As soon as an uninspiring last 16 draw was made, the most noteworthy topic the Spanish media could find to discuss was how Madrid would cope in the freezing north on a midweek January evening. The Newmansha fans welcomed the European champions with the Icelandic thunderclap, but the elements were kinder than the polar temperatures expected. Real's performance was solid if unspectacular, but Real should have no problem sealing their place in the last 8 next week. 5. Fortune favors the favorites. As if the odds weren't stacked enough against lower league sides in this competition, with the big guns invariably having the crutch of a second leg at home to lean on, Newmanica were left cursing the referee. Largely without reason. Lucas Vasquez was clearly tripped for both Madrid penalties, whilst Diamanco could easily have seen a straight red rather than a second yellow for a late lunge on Nacho. Yet, the hosts could easily have had a penalty themselves when Theo Hernandez pulled Donny Nieto's shirt early on. And if that wasn't enough, Newmansha were also cursing their luck when Inigo Perez rattled the woodwork.